Hey guys, what's up? Archer here. And basically in today's video of Subnautica, I'm going to show you how to build a farm and how to use them effectively for things that you actually can use in a survival game, stuff like that. So the most common items that we're going to be needing are like the creep vine oil, the blood oil, and the acid mushrooms. And we can grow all of these things. And the way we can is getting their seeds. Now, I have a couple growing in here already. So what I'm going to do is find more mushrooms to show you how to obtain the seeds. Now, you're going to want to be careful with getting them because you could smack it and then destroy the entire crop. Like if I smack this one, it'll destroy all of them. But you will not get as many as you possibly could. So you have to be very careful about that. Now, I'm going to keep on letting these grow, but in a different plot, I'll show you all the different things you can grow. Now, you want to get really close to the external seabed, which costs 2 titanium to grow, and you need to find the blueprint to actually build it, if I'm not mistaken, which can be found on the islands. So, I'm in creative mode now just for educational purposes, but we're going to go down straight to it, use planter, and it'll bring up this little UI like this. Now, all of these slots are potential, you know, places where you can actually grow things. We're going to grow some mushroom spores. Let's do 4. And creep vines take up as many spots as they would in your inventory. So we're going to put some blood oil in here as well. Another creep vine cluster. And why not? Another mushroom spore. So now that we do that, we can actually see that they're starting to grow. And you can see that's 1%. The growing blood vine is also 1%, but these are at 88%, 79%, because these have been growing for a while. Now you can actually see that it'll be growing in real time. You can watch it grow all the way to 100% if you want to, but I don't really know anybody who actually would want to. It's like watching paint dry. But that's really all there is to it when it comes to growing things in Subnautica and starting your own farm. So just to speed up the process, what I will be doing is switching it from night to day very quickly and showing you what the final result is. So I'll go ahead and cut to that. Hey guys, what's up? Now, as we can see, they're grown. After one day, they're grown to about 72%, but the acid mushrooms are grown completely. The vines do take a little bit more than one day to grow, but they're already 3/4 of the way there after one day. So basically, you just have to wait for about, you know, 1/4 of another day, so you don't really have to worry about it. And this is in-game days, not real-life days, so don't worry about that. Now, let's say you want to harvest, you know, harvest more to replant. You can absolutely do that, but you have to be very careful, and here's why. I showed you earlier with the acid mushrooms, where if you swipe it, like if you slash them more than once, the entire, like all of the mushrooms would disappear. So what you're going to want to do is choose one that you want to get rid of, and then you'll get 3 seeds from it. So let's just take this one out of the equation, this very far one. Okay, we picked that up. We want to slash it. So we slashed it. Now if we slash again, all of the mushrooms will disappear, and we just don't want that. So now that we've only slashed one, we've gotten 4 back. So we can go back into the planter and just replant 4 right away. And that's a margin of 3 more that we're growing. So for each one that we take away, 3 more will take its place, including the one that you took. So it's like a profit of 3 each time you replant. Now, these are still growing. They're at about 80%. I'm going to go ahead and do the day skip one more time just to show you the final product. All right, now we are here at the last day. Everything is grown. We can go up to the creep vine. We can actually see that, hey, you know, they're ready to be harvested. The blood vine is also actually very bioluminescent, so it's actually super, super bright. Now, if we try to harvest these, we can just go right up to it, pick off the seed clusters. Gotta be very careful, because I just picked one off. Here we go. And then, if we really want to, we could go ahead and plant some down in here. Now, as for the blood vine, I can't really see where any of the blood is so far. So we're going to have to wait for the blood to appear. Oh, no, there's some down here. My mistake. You can pick up the blood oil. You're going to have to really look for it. Since these are miniature versions of the real thing, you're going to have to look for it. And then, just like last time, we can go ahead and just plant another one. And just like that, over and over and over, you can just grow as big as a garden as you want. That's really all there is to it. So thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully now you can grow your own garden in Subnautica. And if you enjoyed the video, remember to leave a comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. I really do appreciate it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I am Archer, and I am signing out.